Today we're talking about the Kranzle 1122 portable solution. This is a package that we here at Obsessed Garage curated and designed to be very user-friendly and intuitive to set up. It's also the gold standard in portable pressure washing setups. Now, whether you already knew about this package, maybe you're just shopping for pressure washers, regardless, we thought it made sense to make a video showing you how to put it together, how to get it running, and maybe some of the issues you'll run into along the way. Before we get into assembling anything or turning the pressure washer on, it's important to inventory your entire order once it arrives. That's just to make sure nothing got damaged in shipping, there's no manufacturing defects, anything like that, within 30 days of the order arriving. We have everything included in the kit laid out on the table and obviously the pressure washer right here, but I'll introduce them as we go through the setup process. So the first thing we need to do is take our pressure washer and plug it into the wall. It's important to plug your pressure washer into an outlet that doesn't have too many other things on it, as these Kranzles do pull a pretty significant amperage from the wall. Now that the unit's plugged in, we can turn our attention over to the inlet. So we have our 12.5-foot inlet hose. You can get this kit in a 6.5-foot, 12-foot, or a 20-foot. And then we have our two garden hose quick disconnects right here. And you can see that these come apart. They come packaged like this, but they come apart into the coupler and the plug. So we'll unscrew our inlet hose. And I will take the male side of this hose and screw in our coupler. And I will take the female side of the hose and screw in our plug. We have a video specifically about GHT threads if you're having any issues, but the important thing to know is that there's an O-ring in here and the male side of the GHT fitting presses up against it. So if it's not tight enough, you might have a leak, and if it's too tight, you might also have a leak. So just be aware of that when you're setting this up. We'll take our other coupler, separate it, take the male end and attach it to our pressure washer. Again, making sure it's snug, but not overly tight. We'll take our other coupler and we will attach that to our hose bib on the wall. There we go. From here, I can take my hose, get the side with the plug on it, connect it to the wall, and then take the other end and connect it into the pressure washer. There we go, our inlet side is complete. The QDs are definitely a simple step, but they add quite a significant difference when it comes to setting up and breaking down your pressure washer setup. So let's move on to the high pressure hose. The 1122 makes this pretty easy since it's integrated into the unit itself, but you'll see here on the end, it's actually terminated in an M22 fitting. Now this is pretty normal for portable units or basically any OEM hose you'll get, but we do need to convert this to a quick disconnect. This is designed to screw directly into the OEM accessories. Included in the kit is a M22 coupler. This is the Mosmatic one, so it's compatible with all the other Mosmatic quick disconnects. And all we're gonna do is screw this into the end of the hose. Now this is another O-ring fitting, so we don't need any Teflon tape or anything like that. You just hand tighten it and you shouldn't have any leaks. If you do start experiencing leaks with this, the first thing I would recommend checking is either the O-ring inside of this coupler or the O-ring inside of this connection. But if it's brand new, you really shouldn't have any issues right there. Now that the pressure washer is all set up, I'm actually gonna set this down for a moment and we can turn our attention to our gun, our accessories, and the foam cannon. So included in this kit is a bag with two O-rings. Do not throw this away. Put it somewhere safe. Make sure you don't lose it, because if the O-ring in the coupler, like I mentioned before, goes bad, we included one in it. And if the O-ring in your gun's quick disconnect goes bad, there's one of those as well. So to talk a little bit about the accessories, this is Obsessed Garage's own Mosmatic gun. It has the integrated swivel in the bottom, as well as the Mosmatic Swiss-made couplers on either end. You also have two Mosmatic nozzles and the Mosmatic bent wand, again with Mosmatic fittings. Now I'll make mention that it's important not to mix different plugs and couplers. So if you have Chinese plugs or couplers or something from a big box store, they might not work with the Mosmatic fittings. So just make sure you're keeping them compatible if you're gonna use other accessories outside of the ones we include in the kit. So let's get our foam cannon set up. We send it with the correct orifice already inside of the foam cannon. It's mostly set up for you. Again, it has a Mosmatic plug on the end of it. There's just a little bit of assembly we have to do. So we're gonna take our pickup tube and just slide it onto the housing. And then we'll take our bottle and screw it on. Always screw the plastic bottle into the head of the foam cannon, not the other way around. That way you don't cross thread it. Now that all of our accessories are set up, let's get to actually testing the pressure washer. The 1122 actually functions in the down position. So you have to lay it flat before you turn it on or anything like that. Otherwise the pump won't be getting enough oil. We'll take the high pressure hose, plug it into our gun. We'll set this aside for one moment. And now we can turn on the water at our hose spigot and inspect for any leaks. And if I did my job correctly, we won't have any. So I'm looking at this initial inlet. I'm looking at the garden hose inlet on the pressure washer. And I'm also looking at the M22 on the gun. I don't see any leaks, but if you do experience leaks, just know that that's normal. It's nothing to worry about. We're dealing with water under pressure and it's normal to have to work for a couple of leaks. Doesn't mean your fittings are bad. From here, I'll take my gun and I'll start to purge the water out of the gun. There's likely a lot of air in the hose reel and even in the pump itself. So we want to make sure we get all of that out before we turn the unit itself on. Once we're seeing a pretty consistent stream of water out of the sprayer, we can attach our nozzle and then turn the unit on. And that's it. It's fully pressurized. Again, check for leaks. I don't see any leaks. And we can see if this thing runs. It should turn on the second you pull the trigger, and the second you let go, it should turn off. It might have a 1 or 2 second period where it builds pressure up again, but we will see. Okay, and if your pressure washer is running normally, you're not having any issues, that's basically it. When it comes to switching to other accessories, it's pretty simple. Just undo the nozzle, put your wand on, grab your foam cannon, connect it to, and that's all there really is to it. We did most of the heavy lifting, finding all of these parts and pieces. All that you have to do is put it together and start enjoying washing your car. Breakdown and storage is basically the reverse of what we did. You're gonna turn your unit off, purge the water out of your gun, disconnect the inlet hose and the outlet hose, and we even include a little storage plug for the end of your hose so you don't get any drips coming out of this all over your garage floor. You can get this entire solution or any of the individual pieces we talked about on our website at obsessedgarage.com. And if you have any questions, you can reach out in the comments or email us directly at support@obsessedgarage.com.